What up, dude bros? I'm Frank. This is another episode of Nerf Stereotypes. This episode is a viewer request. Demolitions expert, the guy that just digs explosives and demolishing stuff. Although we don't really have real explosives in Nerf, minor detail. Onto the stereotype. Go. What's up? I'm gonna go over my gear. I am the specialist. My buddies refer to me as the demolitions guy. I like guns and I appreciate them as a tool, but most of the time an explosive is a far cooler option to use. So I'm gonna go over my gear and my blaster and sort of my mentality because he asked me to. You can see the general theme, it's explosives, because explosives are freaking fun, man. Of course, they're not real explosives. This is just a Nerf game, but they're all simulated explosives, pretty much. So starting out with the blaster, this is the Demolisher. This is a flywheel magazine-fed blaster. I picked it purely because it has a grenade launcher attached to the front of it. I don't really care about the primary blaster. I mean, I shoot it when I have to, but most of the time, I'm just flinging grenades all day long. Although that's a missile, not really a grenade. These are grenades, and these don't get launched out of that. But that would be freaking awesome. Maybe a mod for another day. And that's pretty much it with the Demolisher. I don't really care about it. I like the grenade launcher or the missile launcher. I do use 12-round magazines, no particular reason. They're just laying around and, you know, I carry a few. Attached to the Demolisher, I have another missile launcher or grenade launcher, whatevs. This is from the Tri-Strike blaster. That blaster's great and all, but it doesn't have a grenade launcher attached to it, other than the attachment one, which I have attached to the Demolisher. So I have two missile launchers, which is pretty sweet. Oops. You fire it with the stock. It's pretty simple to operate. You do that. Then if you haven't seen the Demolisher launch, that was a weak launch. Typically it goes further. That's despicable performance. I apologize. I'm better than that. I'm a specialist. Of course, I use the missile launcher attachment because it's a missile launcher attachment. That needs no other explanation, right? And that's pretty much it for the blaster. I'm typically just running around noob tubing all day. That's why I have this in my hands typically. Otherwise, I'm to my gear. So my gear, I have a vest, a belt, and a sling. Starting out with a vest. I pick this vest because it looks super cool with a popped collar, like permanently popped collar. Yeah, that looks baller. And it adds as a ballistic protection in case one of these explosives goes off in my hands. The full bomb suit would be a little restrictive for my taste, and especially since we play Nerf, it would still be hit, so I'm not trying to armor myself. If it's not like a shield in game rules, I'm not gonna carry all that mass. But the vest is a pretty standard plate carrier. No plates in it, of course, that's just the style. It's not like a zip-up vest. And it has the MOLLE attachments, which are vital for my grenade loadout. So I have a number of grenades here. These grenades are just hooked into the webbing of the vest, pretty simply, with this little handle thing. It just slides right on in there. They have dedicated pouches and whatnot, but, you know, I don't wanna fiddle with that. And let's be real, this looks way more intimidating when my opponents can see all the grenades. And half of being tactical is looking awesome, right? And I feel pretty awesome when I play. These aren't real explosive grenades or anything. These are just spring-loaded when you pull out the safety pin, which is kind of to make sure I don't accidentally shoot myself. I like to keep the pins just here in my front pocket after I pull them out to make sure I can get them back. It's easy to find the grenade on the playing field. It's much more difficult to find those little pins laying around in grass or whatnot. And if you haven't seen one of these, they are spring-loaded. And without the pins, sometimes go off. That freaking hurt. That's why I have the pop collar man, ballistic protection. That one happened to be not loaded for the sake of this video. But that's the grenade in the exploded form. So then they spring little dart heads all over the place and get awesome kills. I'm all about the grenades because darts are really small and they miss. When you throw in a grenade, you pretty much guarantee a kill. It's awesome. Especially when you encounter a bunch of noob camper scrubs and they're sitting back with their little sniper rifles. You can't get to them because they can shoot really far and you can't. You get real close and you just start lobbing in grenades one after another. One of them will totally get the kill. I mean, come on, I have like 7 or 8 with me. So that is it for the grenades. You know, those are pretty simple. Pull the pin, throw, and get some awesome kills. And up here, I have a few Claymore remotes. These are wireless remotes for the Claymores, and they're color-coded, yellow, blue, and red, that match the Claymores. These particular Claymores have individual frequencies or something, so I can't detonate all of them with just one trigger. That would be pretty cool, but it's also really cool to have independent control of them because all of them serve slightly different purposes. These are hooked into the MOLLE vest in the same way of the Claymores. They just have this little belt clip that just slides right into the loop. Taking it off, just for example, typically I just leave it on and press them when I need to detonate that Claymore. That's it for the front of the vest, other than this little patch. It says, "Welcome to the danger zone," because, you know, this is the danger zone. I am the danger zone.
Danger zone.
If my opponents can read it, they have entered the danger zone, even if they're stationary. Anytime I enter a room with all these grenades, it is immediately the danger zone. I mean, so come on, what an appropriate patch. So that's it for the front of the vest. On the back of the vest, I also have a Claymore. That's not to be tactically grabbed or anything. I can't actually reach it. That is for defensive purposes. If somebody's creeping up behind me, I can tap this blue trigger and it goes pfft and fires off backwards. I don't have eyes in the back of my head, but I have a Claymore on the back of my head. So that's way better than eyes. I mean, am I right? If you disagree, you've just never used a Claymore and you're wrong. I'd prefer a person back there watching my six to move as a little like squad or whatever, but sometimes that can't happen, so a Claymore can pretty much replace that person. pretty much. So that's it for the vest overview. I also have a sling, and nothing's actually attached to it. I use it to attach my blaster. I use this little quick clip to snap it to my primary if I need both of my hands to generally just place claymores or throw two grenades at once. I don't personally nerf with it on there because it's pretty restrictive on using the blaster, especially when I'm trying to use the grenade launcher. Sometimes I need to point this in weird ways that like a normal blaster operator wouldn't need to, because it's not just an ordinary blaster, it's two missile launchers attached to it. But I very often need both of my hands to deal like planting a claymore to get the angle right and set up the little legs and all of that, or just, you know, talk to a camera like I am now. I don't know what to do with my hands. What do I do with my hands? I'm suddenly aware I have two hands. I wasn't aware of that 10 seconds ago. So that explains my sling. Now to my belt. This is a pretty standard battle belt, more or less. In the front here, I have two extra grenades because you can't have too many grenades. It's pretty much impossible. And they're super at the ready because I very quickly go through these. You know, it's once you get thrown grenades, it's easy to just keep throwing them. Then beyond that, I have two extra spare mags for the demolisher, like the flywheel blaster portion. I don't really have to get to these very often. That's why they're kind of in the back, out of my way. I need my explosives primarily. But they're helpful in case I shoot more than 12 rounds in a game, but that very rarely happens. Typically, I'm using all of this other stuff. Over here, I have a dump pouch holding extra missiles because I shoot quite a few of those. For particularly long games, I'll have another drop pouch right here on this little empty part of the belt with more missiles just in case I need more ammo. Because just like grenades, you can't have too many missiles. It's pretty much impossible. And these are really lightweight, so not too big a deal to carry a bunch of them. And beyond that, I have another dump pouch, but it's a slightly different one. It's supposed to be a dump pouch. I don't use it as one. I use it to hold another claymore. It has a little tether so it doesn't pop out when I'm running, but when I need it, I can get to it. This is why I need two hands, exactly for this reason, to get crap out of my pouches. That's why I don't want a blaster in my hand when I'm going for my claymore. Obviously, I don't care about the blaster, so that's another claymore. This particular claymore has yellow tape on the top and on the back, which obviously corresponds with the yellow remote. So when I set these little legs up and I place it somewhere, I can remember yellow's in that corner by the tree, as opposed to, you know, red, which is over somewhere else, because all these claymores look the same. Yep, so that's it for the belt. Missiles, claymore, a few more grenades, and but a few spare mags, just in case. That, coupled with the vest gear, and of course the blaster, I have pretty much everything I need. If you're a rather alert individual, you might have thought, you only have two claymores, but three remotes. Where's the third one? If you notice that, your attention to detail is superb, and you would make a great demolitions guy. Because when you're breaching a room with your squad, it is your job to detect enemy claymores and enemy explosive devices, so your attention to detail has to be superb. So if you notice that, look into demolitions. Oh, but to answer your question, if you did actually notice that, I do have a third claymore. It's attached to my Terra Scout. If you're unfamiliar with the Terra Scout, it is a remote control blaster tank thing, but I have attached a claymore to the front of mine, because what's crazier than a fully automatic drone, one with an explosive claymore, like on the front? It's not really like that RCXD thing from that video game, because that entire thing blows up with C4. This is a directional claymore, so it launches in the front, and it can still drive around after it's detonated. Sometimes I run it with an actual magazine, but otherwise it's just a claymore device instead of like a fully automatic, because blasters, kind of lame. I'm more into explosives, if you couldn't tell. I certainly don't use this guy for every game because it's kind of large to carry around, but it's an awesome breaching tool. So if I don't want to walk into a room because I think there's an explosive or a person or whatever, I can just drive this little guy and look through the little camera to detect their explosives. And if there is a threat or a person there, I could just tap that and it kills them. It's also great to use as like a sacrificial tool. If there's a tripwire or something, I can run the drone through the tripwire, their explosive claymore goes off, and then a person doesn't get hit. It's much better to sacrifice a little robot thing than my team member, and especially me. I mean, but that is the Terra Scout with the last claymore. So I think that covers it for my loadout. I am the specialist, but of course my buddies call me the demolitions guy. Either one works. So hopefully you learned how to be a better demolitions guy. Remember, don't send a dart to do a grenade's job. That is the stereotype of the demolitions expert. If you have an idea for a future stereotypes episode, leave a comment in the section below. That concludes this episode. Thanks so much for watching, bros, and as always, stay tactical-y.